Here's how to bring in the MIDI files and preserve the global information. There's a couple of different ways. Under File, we can just open it as if it's a regular document. I'm going to double-click it, and it's loading in the instruments. Again, I'm missing some samples for my drums, but it's loading in the stock software instruments that are programmed into Logic to correspond with general MIDI mappings. And here's the session, and it's called up the piano there, the bass there, and the pop kit there. Let me just change our drum kit quickly, and it should sound more or less like what we had. I'll just put this to Studio Kit. And let's listen. And if we look in the tempo list, we'll see all the tempo events there. And there are markers. So that works fine. Let me close that. The other way you can do this is from the dock. I'm going to open my dock and just drag and drop this over my Logic icon. And it's going to do the same thing. We get the exact same session. It's loading in the stock programming for software instruments that are programmed into Logic. And we're going to get the same tracks right there. Now you can do both of these by holding down the Option key. And watch what happens. I'm holding down Option, dragging and drop. And it's opening a kit with standard general MIDI outboard MIDI assignments. Now this is great if you're using external MIDI modules. Let's say you're on a gig performing or something, you're using a Sound Canvas or something like that. It sets you up all ready to go. It imports the marker information, imports the tempo information. You hook up your external module and you're good to go. Let me close that. And you can also hold down Option and use the Open command for the same type of behavior. Holding down Option, we get the general MIDI multi-instrument with program changes.